And in Money Matters this morning, folks living in the Mid-South will have another option for traveling. In Northwest Mississippi, air travel is returning to Tunica.
This comes as the community is working very hard to boost its economy after facing numerous challenges in recent years. Eric Konupka is the director of the Tunica Airport. Eric, welcome to Live at 9. Glad to have you here this morning.
Good morning, and thank you very much.
A lot of people are looking at this, studying it very closely. Could this be a potential win not only for passengers, the Tunica Airport, but also the Tunica gaming community?
Absolutely. The whole purpose of having an airport in the community is to be able to support the community in terms of travel. The airport, of course, now offers that opportunity to expand that reach coming into Tunica, and as well as for the Mid-South going outbound.
Absolutely, because the Mid-South could certainly use as much competition in air travel as we can get. So tell us about Ashley Air. Their pricing is a bit unique in the industry. How does it work?
It is. So they basically have two different models, for lack of better terms. As a passenger, you can go on their website, book a ticket as you would any normal airline.
Right.
But if you're a frequent flyer, say to the cities that they're being offered right now, starting off at Charlotte, Atlanta, Orlando, and Clearwater,
Tampa. Some major cities.
Yes, ma'am. So you can become a member as well, and part of that membership package, you then have the opportunity to fly for $39 each way for your annual membership all year long, no blackout dates.
That's pretty unique.
Yeah, exactly.
Do you think this will also lure in, or you're hoping this will lure in, people who will travel who also happen to live in the Memphis area or all throughout the Mid-South as well?
I think it's certainly going to offer that opportunity. It may not be for everyone per se. Some of the, some of the modeling for the for their membership. Mm-hmm. But however, yes, absolutely. We have the opportunity to reach those cities from this region.
As you know, the aviation industry for some years is kind of tight. There aren't a whole lot of margins. Is this a pricing model that's been used before so that we know it might last?
I think his business model, he's trying to prove that. There have been some smaller aviation entities that have tried it, have been successful.
And so what you're saying basically is we in the Mid-South, if we support that, can actually perhaps change the way airfares are priced, which helps us all everywhere.
Absolutely. It's certainly a possibility. Absolutely.
Eric also talked to us, though, the big picture as well. I mean, recent years in Tunica, to say the least, and anybody who's been keeping up with the news have seen the reports that the gaming industry in the state of Mississippi has struggled recently. How could all of this work together? What have you seen from that standpoint? What are your hopes?
Well, I know the gaming community within within Tunica, they're certainly wanting to see this product. Mm-hmm. Here again, this does offer the ability to bring people in. They have a far reach when coming to bring in their patrons in. Mm-hmm. With the onslaught of now sports betting, in addition to now having air travel to be able to support that directly, and being in the South, we're big SEC fans,
and being able to
absolutely. Speaking of sports betting, has the Mississippi legislature taken action immediately to? I know the Tennessee legislature is looking at it. But since it's a state-by-state basis.
And how soon are you hoping that it will start looking into this?
Well, it's imminent. The law has already been passed.
Okay.
Now the Gaming Commission is actually trying to set the rules and regulations to make that happen. So it's forthcoming here very soon.
Optimistic right through here now that things are looking up? No pun intended.
Absolutely. Absolutely.